you're going to be sore. That's just the way it is. Let's just accept that right off the bat. You're going to be sore, you're going to hurt. Of course, it's going to depend on what level of deconditioning you have, the level of fitness you've had in the past, but even so, whether it be someone who's new to fitness, new to movement in one of the different programs at the Fit Club or in our remote training, or you've been doing fitness for an extended time, you may not have been moving well, you may not have been moving optimally, you may be moving body parts and through movements and ranges of movement that are new to you, and that's wonderful, that's good. One of the basic fundamental components of the blueprint in the Life by Design Center is mobility. Before we start loading your body and adding resistance, we've got to make sure that your body's not broken. And adding resistance and challenging movements to a body that's already broken is adding potentially insult to injury, in the sense that you're going to slow down your body's ability to recover, you're going to slow down your results, you're going to slow down your progressions. And so we've built in a model that incorporates mobility, that incorporates stretching, that incorporates dealing with improving healthy motion. That said, in doing so, you're going to be sore. Your tissues are going to change. And I look at that and I'm excited by that. And our coaches are excited by that. The truth is, when you're moving and you're changing, you're going to feel something happening. Now, in part, you'll feel the soreness, you'll feel the inflammation, sometimes even irritation. And then there's millions of other wonderful physiological processes that you won't feel as you're meeting the requirements for movement in your body. Knowing that you're going to be sore, what are the things that we can do to at least make that experience better for you? Once you've accepted it's going to happen. And the flip side is, if you're concerned and you think to yourself, well, I think I'm going to stop moving so I'm not sore, then all you're doing is continuing to go down that negative path, and you're continuing to get deconditioned, and you're creating bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger problems, not just from a movement perspective, but from a health perspective. Some great science continues to emerge on the potential effects on our health long-term when we don't move well, whether it be sitting or immobility. There's some very significant health impacts that are not just on the outside of our body or the physical aspects of what we see and feel, but in terms of our cardiovascular function, our blood sugar and insulin function. So some really, really important factors, and this is why movement is so key. So what can we do to help us get through some of the soreness? Because the goal is that we're able to maintain consistency through our training, and we can do that over and over and over again, rinse and repeat. One of the things we can do is making sure we're doing our prep work. That means getting to class in advance. That means if you're doing the remote training, that you in advance do your preparation work. There's videos for that. You'll get those if you already haven't. The second thing is taking time at the end of class to do some recovery work, whether it be stretching that's specific to the body parts that you used or specific to areas that are injured or immobile or deconditioned. Then we can look at nutrition. Other than the blanket statement of real food first, when we look at supplementation, there's some areas there, omega-3 fats. So looking at the omega-3 fat, omega-3s to 6s, so we recommend a pharmaceutical grade fish oil supplement. Can you get healthy and quality omega-3s and enough of them in real food? Probably, but you're going to have to be pretty dedicated to that and really look at the sources that you're taking in and be hyper consistent. The easier way is just adding in a fish oil supplement, pharmaceutical grade, high quality. The other part is magnesium, so looking at some of the minerals that our body may be deficient in, we believe magnesium to be one of those big ones. So those are the two from the essentials standpoint. We'll go deeper into what the essentials are in time. And then the last one, if you haven't actually started the process or actually gone for testing, is your biostructural restoration. So looking at the structure itself, looking at the spinal curvatures, looking at the spinal motion and how that affects both structure and the neurology. So making sure that you've taken time to have your biostructural system examined, or if you haven't, take time to get that scheduled and start to integrate that. If you integrate those components in addition to your training that's happening regularly, regardless of what class you're in, regardless of what class style you're doing at the Fit Club or where you're with your remote training, those are some of the pieces that are going to help you progress through this soreness that you're probably going to experience. In fact, let's just be honest, not probably, you are going to experience it. So get to work, start doing those things, and until next time, make it a great day.